Osmania Reading Animal Legends. Chapter 1: The Cat and the Rat. You might not believe it now when cats chase rat and rats hate cats, but long ago they were best friends. When cat and rat lived very happily together on Iceland. The Iceland had all they needed. There were birds for the cat to chase and plenty of juicy plants for the rats to nibble with a sharp front teeth. There was only one problem. There wasn't much else to do. Most days they were bored. Then one morning the rat had an idea. Why don't we look for somewhere else to live? Perfect! But how would we get there? The cat thought about it. How could they leave the Iceland? Then she twitched her whiskers and smiled. That's easy, she said. We'll make a boat from the trunk of a tree. The rat gnawed at the tree until it toppled over. Timber! Timber! The cat scratched out the inside of the trunk. So they had somewhere to sit. Finally, the cat nibbled two branches and made them into oars. They were ready to go to sea. All aboard, it's time to start our adventure. The cat stepped into the boat and took the oars. Then the rat pushed the boat out onto the waters.
Waves.
Here goes, said the cat. Be careful, I don't want to get wet. There's nothing to worry about, said the rat. We'll be fine. Then rowed and rowed until it grew dark. The cat was so tired, he fell asleep. Oh no, I forgot to bring food. But the rat felt hungry. She was so hungry, she began to nibble the side of the boat. But she made such a noise, she woke up the cat. What's the munching sound? Don't worry, squeak the rat, you're dreaming. The cat went back to sleep. The rat was very greedy and kept on grinning at the boat. Munch, munch, munch. Suddenly, oh no! What have I done? The rat had eaten so much she'd made a hole in the boat. Water started to slosh up through the hole and the boat began to sink. The cat woke up with a start. I'm wet, said Squilt. She squealed. We're sinking. We'll have to swim. They had to leap from the boat and swim for their lives. This is all your fault, cat, rat. The cat was very angry. He hated getting wet. I'm going to eat you when we get to shore, he spluttered. Help! The rat scrambled up the shore and ran to a sandhill. The dug a hole as fast as she could and dived into it. Cut deep. The hole was
too small for the cat to squeeze into. I saved, drove the rat, but the cat didn't give up so easily. He peered into the hole. I wait for you, rat, he called. You have to come out sometimes. I can wait all week. So he sat and he waited and waited and waited, but the rat never came out. The dog tunneled all the way through the She dug a tunnel all the way through the hill and ran out on the other side. Phew! I've escaped.
Escape.
And that is why today our cat will sit for hours upon hours waiting to pounce on a rat. Chapter 2. This is my favorite part. Chapter 2. Why monkeys live in trees. Many years ago, the king of the jungle was a gorilla named Naresh. All the animals wanted to marry his daughters, but she didn't know who to choose. One day, Naresh spot a big wooden burial sitting on the grass. That's new, he said, and looked inside. Oh, what's that? The berry was full of grassy water. Naresh took a sip. It takes the fire water, he said. That might be useful. Naresh took the berry home and called the other animals together. I have a berry of fire water, he said, and it will help us decide who's to marry my daughter. Whoever can drink the whole berry may have my beautiful daughter as his bride. The animals were very excited. Everyone wanted to try. They pushed and shoved closer to the berries, but the elephant got there first. Out of my way, I'm first, Big Billy. Just watch, this will be easy, he boasted. The elephant dipped his strong into the burial. He caught up some fire water and sneezed. Achoo! Ow! He snorted, spilling water everywhere. It stings! No one could drink that. And he rushed off. The hippo was try next. I live in the water and drink water all the time, she said. I'm not scared of a bite of fire water. So he took a big mouthful, and almost choked. He spat out the fire water and ran to the river to call his mouth. Next, the warthog stepped forward. I can eat or drink anything, he begged. No problem. It's like a muscle. He drank from the berry and caught. Ah, that's horrible, he shouted. Eek! What fool you are, cried a voice. It was the leopard. And you're all far too ugly to marry the king's daughter. I'm handsome, and I shall drink the water, he
He stepped to the barrier and just as quickly stepped back again. Even the smell of fire water made him feel sick. The other animal laughed at the leopard and he crept away to its shell. Then a little voice peeped out. "Please, Naresh, may I try the water?" It was a tiny monkey. The animal stared at it. How could he drink the water? "Naresh, you can try if you want," he said, "but you must drink all the water and finish it today. I don't want a single drop left. May I drink a little at a time with rest in between?" asked the monkey. Naresh was fear king, of course, he said. So the tiny monkey climbed into the barrel. The other animal gathered around, grinning. This was going to be funny. I'm telling a shell, drink the water and marry Naresh's daughter. I don't like Naresh's daughter, it's so pretty. But the monkey seemed very sure of himself. The monkey gulped a large mouthful of the fire water, then ran off into the bushes. It tasted disgusting. Where's he going? The other animal wondered. After a few moments, the monkey was back. He climbed up the side of the barrel, took another gulp of fire water, and he ran off to the bushes just as he'd done before. The telling of the monkey had a secret. He wasn't alone. Behind the bushes sat a whole tribe of monkeys who all looked excited, exactly the same. Hee hee hee. Tee hee hee hee. Ha ha ha. Each monkey took turn to drink some of the burning fire water. By the end of the day, the barrel was empty. The other animals were astonished. "Naresh's daughter is mine. Now I shall meet my bride," said Talinga proudly. The monkey stood before the old gorilla. "Well done," said Naresh. "You have completed the task. You may marry my daughter." But his daughter didn't look too pleased. "I've got to marry him, my lovely bride." Suddenly, the dwarf gave a shout. He had seen something interesting. "Hey!" he cried. "That's a whole tribe of monkeys hiding in the bushes. What are you up to?" "Telling a chat," roared the animal. "His friend has helped him." The monkey didn't wait to hear any more. They ran off, leaping into the tree to be out of reach. "Well, we'll get them for this." Monkey have lived up in trees ever since.
Since
they are much too scared to come down. Chapter 3. The Rabbit and the Crocodile. There was once a time when crocodile lived on land, not in the water. Was grumpy old crocodile lived in the river and lay in the sun all day. One day, a baby rabbit hopped past looking for some tasty leaves. "Hello!" he called, and wake up the crocodile. The crocodile was furious. "Go away, I'm trying to sleep." As the crocodile shut its eyes again, the rabbit hopped closer.
he had spotted a bunch of fresh green leaves just by the crocodile's nose. Mmm, these are yummy. With loud crunching, he began to gobble them up. The crocodile eyes snapped open. Get away from those leaves, he roared, and he snapped at the rabbit with his enormous jaws. Go away! The little rabbit ran and ran. He didn't stop until he reached the burrow. The crocodile nearly ate me, he told his mother, but I didn't do anything wrong. I was only eating some leaves. Dear, dear, you're safe now. His mother was very angry. It's time that crocodile was taught a lesson, she said firmly. He's grumpy and lazy, and it's just want to. Is everyone here? Rattling the other rabbits together, she told them she had a plan. The next day, the rabbit went into the woods. They collect branches, twigs, and leaves. They stuff them into a sack. Will this do? Almost full. That's enough, said the rabbit's mother. And off they went to find the crocodile. They didn't have to look far. Tease was by the river bank, asleep as usual. The rabbit crept closer. Zzz. Snaking up, they made a big circle of twigs, leaves, and branches around the crocodile. Then the mother rabbit set light to the circle. The fire cracked and spread, the smoke blowed up. The crocodile woke up on a jump. When he saw the fire, he blowed in fear. Help! Fire! The fire was licking at his scales. Taking a flying leap, he jumped right over the flames. Funniest thing I ever seen, ho ho ho, and disappeared into the river with a splash. When the crocodile heard the rabbit laughing, he was very annoyed. And he shouted at them from the river, "Don't ever come near the river again. Ho ho! Keep off our land, then," cried the rabbits. And that's how it stayed ever since. The end.